Welcome to GrabNGoInfo. What is a p-value is one of the most commonly asked questions in a data science interview. In this tutorial, you will learn what are the general strategies of answering a definition type of interview question, how to answer the question to a technical audience, how to answer the question to a non-technical audience. Let's get started. Firstly, let's talk about the general strategy for answering a definition type of interview question. The first strategy is concise. In a data science technical interview, there is usually a list of questions that an interviewer needs to go through with the interviewee. Therefore, time management in an interview is important. We need to keep the answers clear and concise for the definition type questions and save time for the exploration type question. The second strategy is to talk about the key values for the concept. This includes the value range, how to interpret a large or a small value, and the important threshold value. The third strategy is to prepare simple examples to support the definition. You do not need to talk about the examples when answering the questions, but keep them in the back of your pocket in case there are follow-up questions asking you to provide an example. To get the written version of this tutorial, please check out my blog post on Medium.com. I will put the link in the video description. Medium.com is my most referenced website for data science and machine learning. It charges $5 per month for full access. I have been a Medium.com member for many years, and that's the best $5 I spent every month. If you would like to support me and buy me a cup of coffee, please use the link in the video description to join the Medium membership at no additional cost. If you prefer not to join, you can still read the post because there are a couple of free posts each month for everyone to read. Okay, let's continue. When explaining p-value to a technical audience, we can say that p-value measures the probability of obtaining results that are at least as extreme as the observed results if the null hypothesis is true. P-value ranges from 0 to 1. A high p-value means that there is a high chance of obtaining the results as extreme as observed if the null hypothesis is true. So we fail to reject the null hypothesis. A low p-value means that there is a low chance of obtaining the results as extreme as observed if the null hypothesis is true. So we reject the null hypothesis. The typical threshold for p-value is 0.05, meaning that if the probability of obtaining the results as extreme as observed given the true null hypothesis is less than 0.05, we reject the null hypothesis. Here is a simple example. To test if a coin is a fair coin, the coin was thrown 100 times. Out of 100 times, 30 times are heads and 70 times are tails. In this case, the observed results are 30 heads and 70 tails. The results that are at least as extreme as the observed results are heads lesser than or equal to 30 or tails lesser than or equal to 30. P-value measures the probability of getting at least as extreme as the observed results if the coin is a fair coin. When explaining p-value to a non-technical audience, we can say that p-value measures how confident we are about the assumption given the observed data. P-value ranges from 0 to 1. A high p-value means that we are very confident about the assumption based on the observed data, so we believe the assumption is true. A low p-value means that we are not confident about the assumption based on the observed data, so we believe the assumption is not true. The typical threshold used for p-value is 0.05. meaning that we believe the assumption is not true if p-value is less than or equal to 0.05. Here is a simple example. If we assume a coin is a fair coin and the experiment of throwing it multiple times gives us a p-value of 0.01, because 0.01 is less than 0.05, we are not confident that this coin is fair. So the conclusion is that the coin is unfair. If you have made it this far, you probably find the information in this tutorial helpful. Please click the like button and subscribe to the channel to get notified when I publish new videos like this. I listed 4 ways of connecting with GrabNGoInfo on the screen. Besides subscribing to the YouTube channel, you can follow me on Medium, visit my website, or send me an email. To learn more about statistics for data science interview, please click the YouTube playlist on the screen now. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.